Hello and welcome everyone to the day 3 of the 9-day series workshop, Navratri series workshops. So I hope you all are enjoying these sessions. These sessions are conducted by Things ECT in collaboration with the Creative Kalakar. Things ECT is a social enterprise which works with 1,000 plus artisans over 19 locations across India. And to create handmade products, eco-friendly handmade products for gifting and home decors. And we at Creative Kalakar conduct online art workshops for heritage art forms from all across the world. So we have conducted, out of the 9-day series, we have already conducted the mandala workshop and the ipan workshop. And today we'll be conducting the warli workshop. So today we'll be doing a Navdurga Warli. So Warli, as everyone knows, is the folk art of Maharashtra. It is one of the oldest art form of India. So let's start. So we'll start by making borders. So for today, you'll require just a white plain white sheet of paper and a black pen. Or if you're working on black or red color sheet of paper, you can use a white pen. So we'll start with the borders. So for the borders, we'll make a toran design. So semicircular patterns. This is how you'll create some semicircular patterns for the toran design. We'll continue this throughout on all the four sides. So Warli is the oldest art form or the folk art of India and is originated from Maharashtra. So it has also spread across the neighboring states of Maharashtra, but it is popularly still practiced in this state. So these toran patterns will continue on all the four sides of the border of the sheet. We constantly Traditionally, Warli paintings are done on surfaces like floor or walls, and usually they are done using mud and rice paste, similar to ipan. But in Warli, they create villages or celebration paintings. So we'll give these borders a few more semicircle inside. And throughout the border, the same pattern will follow. just two semicircle inside the toron pattern to give them a concentric look. So warli is practiced by the warli tribe of Maharashtra. It is largely practiced in Maharashtra, but also in Madhya Pradesh. So these tribe, warli tribes, are said to have migrated from Maharashtra, and wherever they went, they took this art form with them and have flourished it. So after the toron design is complete, we'll use a black sketch pen to create a dot in the center of the smallest semicircle. Throughout the border, we'll continue this. So in case you have missed any of our workshops until now, you can watch them on the YouTube page of Creative Kalakar, or on the same space on the Facebook page of Things ECT. Now to continue further, we'll make hanging patterns in the toron. And it will be symmetric. So just a line and a dot. Just a line and a dot. Even this pattern will be continued throughout. This gives a falling toron effect, hanging toron effect. So warli painting is basically a painting that uses only lines or geometric patterns to create beautiful shapes and designs. And as you can see, until now, the border also includes same basic shapes and lines. The same pattern will continue throughout the border. And it will be symmetric. We are going in a descending order.
So just a line and a dot, a line and a dot. The same pattern follows everywhere. A line and a dot. You can use any border pattern that you like. This is an option. There are many other alternatives. So even in Varli, there are three levels to learn. That is basic, intermediate, and advanced. So throughout the page, the pattern will continue. So as you can see, it gives a look of hanging toran. A line and a dot, a line and a dot. And going in a descending order will give the same look and feel. You can create guidelines for yourself so that you have equal number of patterns and all are equally similar and symmetric. As you can see how the descending order is giving the effect. You can also create Varli on a brown, red or black color sheet with white ink. Completing the whole border with the same patterns. You can create two borders on opposites, two similar borders on opposite side to give a mixed border feeling or effect. As you can see, the borders are almost done and how gorgeous they look. So this gives a toran effect. Now to start the Nav Durga, since we'll be making 9 goddesses, so we'll start in the very center. Starting for the first one, we'll create the vehicles too. So all these goddesses, all the Navdurgas will be making in the Varli style. So as you can see, we'll be giving very small detailings too. Next up, a second goddess. So it's not necessary to create them using a black ink. You can also give them a colored feel. So we'll be making them with all their accessories too. So first we'll create the outline for all the goddesses. So here we are doing a third goddess. So a third goddess is ready. Next, so these can be a little random, but these shapes could look something similar or familiar to the designs or what they indicate. So we'll add a bow and an arrow. So this is our fourth goddess. Next up, we have goddess here on a lotus. So each one of you can guess it, and it's pretty easy. So we can give a little background waves to highlight goddess's hair. Next, a sixth goddess. So like I said, traditionally warli was only done on floors or walls to depict something like we use, like we have studied the caveman drawings. So they used to depict festivals and occasions in their village. So all these warli paintings tell a story. Each of the warli paintings tell us a story. So here we aren't creating a story today, but if you look at any warli painting, you can see or can figure out the story behind it. So we'll make the mukut of our goddess. And giving some details like a bell in the vehicles, the vehicle that she uses, a dumbo in her hand. So going on further, I hope all of you are enjoying these sessions and learning a new Indian art form. Indian arts are always very interesting to learn and have a really rich history and story with them. So here in this, we add a moon, half moon, crescent moon in the mukut. Give a bow and arrow. A trishul, which signifies goddess. These are very intricate patterns that are out here right now, but these are easy too. Our eighth goddess. Finally, our ninth goddess. giving a mukut to her. And her vehicle. Which you also call as a Vahan. So here we are done with the goddess, but we'll be adding some more details like some villagers, playing music, an honor for these goddesses. Typical Varli villagers or human figures. On either side, we'll be adding these human figures playing instruments in honor of goddesses. So as you can see, we are just using lines and some simple geometric shapes like square, triangle, circle, semicircles. So these are all the simplistic designs that make the Varli most beautiful. So here a man will show a man playing a dhol. We'll show a few Hindu symbols like the swastika. And day and night, we'll be giving an effect of day and night. So we'll show a moon and also a sun. So just like we draw when we were kids, the similar way we'll draw the sun. Okay. Now we are done with the outlining for the drawing. Now it's time to color them. We will be coloring them black, but if you wish, you can color them using color pencils or poster colors. So now we'll color them completely. You can use sketch pens too. So if you wish, you can highlight the borders back again. And we'll color the whole area. So We'll do this for all the designs. So you can see how it is highlighting the whole effect and enhancing the drawing. So Varli are usually completely colored, either black or white. In such a way, we'll complete and color all the other designs too, including the humans. If you wish, you can give thin jewelry to the goddesses. If you're doing it on a colored sheet and using white ink, you can color using a white pencil. So now in modern times, Varli is also used on purses or any accessory materials, bed sheets and all those stuff. In this festive season, if you ever wish to buy something handmade and go vocal for the local, you can contact Things ECT for the best handmade eco-friendly products. And if you wish to learn heritage Indian art forms like Varli, you can contact Creative Kalakar as we conduct online workshops. So as you can see, the coloring is enhancing the whole drawing and giving a new look and feel to the whole sketch. Next up, similarly, we'll color all the other goddesses too, to enhance them and beautify them in this painting. If you wish to learn more, you can subscribe to the Creatives Kalakar YouTube channel and also follow us on Instagram as we post about our workshops and also art forms too. And you can also follow Things ECT on the Facebook, Instagram page and also subscribe to their YouTube channel to see how beautifully handcrafted handmade materials are made. You can color each goddess according to their own colors, or simply stick in a linear version. So as you can see, the essence is growing one by one as we are coloring each goddess. So varli is said to be one of the oldest art form along with all the other art forms, but this is said to have started in around years back. So like it's more than 5000 year old folk art. One by one, you can directly use poster paints if you like. Gradually completing all the forms of the Navdurga. Even the intricate and each beautiful details are highlighted when you color them. So from and lastly, we'll color the last goddess. And as you see, from the outlines to coloring of how the painting has changed completely. It gives you a beautiful essence of how even the simplest painting or the simplest styles and shapes can do wonders. So now we'll color the moon. The sun too. this swastika. And also the human figures who are celebrating the goddesses. We even color all the instruments that they're using so that the outline, after coloring, the outline form can justify. So here we complete our varli. I'll show you the complete drawing. So as you can see, this is our complete drawing for today. The Navdurga Toran borders, humans celebrating, and day and night effect with swastika rangolis.
So that's it for today. We'll meet you tomorrow with another art form. Till then, keep looking for the space, and thank you so much for joining us today. Thank you, everyone.